Alright you guys, welcome back to another Royce Rider video. So today we're gonna go to a Comiccon. So we're gonna be seeing what's over there.
That's right, it is Zoink Scooby Dooby Doo.
Do you say the voice actor of Scooby Doo?
I have. I'm one of them, you know, and I've been doing it off and on for 25 years. In fact, this fall, 25 years.
Yeah. How did you get into the voice acting?
Dude, I'm in radio, so you know, it one thing opened up a door to another thing, it opened up another door to another thing, you know. So, and that's pretty much what it was, you know. Just that's what got me in there. And I did a little parody song on my show called Shaggin' on the Boulevard, and next thing I know, I'm out in LA doing a Scooby-Doo on Zombie Island, so it was crazy.
Did you like doing Scooby-Doo?
Oh, yeah. I mean, I love Scooby-Doo. I grew up as a Scooby-Doo fan. You know, my first lunch pail box, you know, the old metal ones, was a Scooby-Doo lunch pail box that my grandmother got me in 1972. That is where I was hooked, so.
I know, like as I was growing up, I did watch Scooby-Doo, and I really liked how that show. And then I was like, Scooby's just funny, like, he's so afraid.
He is. Well, Scooby represents the coward in all of us, you know, and, you know, and everybody's got their breaking point. Some people it's cash, some people it's food, yes. You know, and so for Scooby and Shaggy, it's food, you know.
Yes, they were always hungry, but scared.
That's right. Well, they, you know, and like they said, would you do it for a Scooby snack? Yeah, okay.
And then it represents, like they say, the dog's the best, my man's best friend.
That's right.
So it's like, it kind of represents, in a way, like, you
absolutely.
Know, their best friend.
Absolutely.
And then you did the Flintstones.
Well, I did a bunch of characters over the years. These are some of the ones that I've done, in little projects here and there, whether it be for Cartoon Network shorts or little bumpers or commercials, whatever the case may be. But, you know, yabba dabba doo, this is Fred Flintstone and Barney Rubble. Wall me down. Skillet Uncle, will you look at that? Popeye the Sailor Man. Reaper. Well, this is Wally Gator, you know. And I love my ever-loving Everglades. I like to get clean instead of dirty. And this is Yogi Bear. And I live in Jellystone, and this is my little buddy Boo Boo.
All right, and I'm always helping Yogi not get in trouble. This is Elroy Jensen, and I'm only 6 years old because I'm a cartoon character, and I'll always be 6 years old. Right, Astro? That's right, Roy. Stop that, Astro. You're slobbering all over me.
Heavens to Murgatroyd. This is Snagglepuss. What's going on? I'll tell ya, stage exit, left, I'm out of here. And this is Wally, you know, Wally Gator. And then, of course, who else is there? I'll sit, pay attention, boy. I'll sit, you see that little house over there? It says D-O-G. I'll sit, that spills chicken. Go get them, boy. And that's a little fun show.
I didn't really get to watch all of them, just the Flintstones. I didn't get to watch Popeye because I was like 2 or 3 years old. So.
Right.
And I know like they still have the Fruity Pebbles. Like I'm surprised they still have
them. They still got it. Fruity Pebbles. That's one of my favorite cereals. Yeah.
Yeah, I remember as I was growing up, I used to want them just because they're colorful. And,
absolutely. Yeah. That's right. Well, man, thank you. And so we're going nationwide on this, huh?
Yes.
Yeah, it's all over the internet.
Yes, it's all over the internet.
It's all over the internet. Well, best of luck to you.
Thank you so much for your time.
I think you're going places, man. You know, she's pretty good, huh? She's pretty good, yeah.
Yes, so, thank you for your time, and well, thank you for the interview.
Well, listen, as Scooby and Shaggy would say, like, man, we'll cruise by, pick you up in the mystery machine, and go get some food. Because, like, we love to eat, right, Scoob?
That's right, Maggie. Scooby-dooby-doo.
I'm here with DJ B.
Hey guys.
I have some questions for you.
Yeah.
questions for you. How did you start doing cosplay?
How I started doing cosplay, it was kind of a funny story. It was like 10 to 12 years ago, and I was dressed up like Miley Cyrus at the VMAs with the red costume. So that's sort of how I got started into cosplay.
I know. Miley Cyrus was very popular like around that time.
Yeah, yeah.
And then did you just start it from there?
Yeah, pretty much. That was like my first costume that I put together, so.
And then I see like a lot that you do Harley Quinn.
Yeah.
What do you like about Harley Quinn?
Harley, she's just a fun character to be, you know? She's bubbly, she's happy most of the time. Sometimes she's just crazy. We're not gonna talk about that part. She's just fun, happy to be. So I want to portray that. So that's why I cosplay as Harley.
Do you do it for fun, or do you plan on becoming like a famous cosplayer?
I just do it for fun. I'm not trying to make this my profession. I'm not trying to be famous. I just like dressing up and having fun.
Oh, okay. What would you next? Because right now you're dressed as Barbie.
Mm-hmm.
Did you watch the movie Barbie?
Oh yeah, I've seen it 3 times.
And why this one out of all the her outfits?
Well, I have most of the outfits from the movie, just not the disco one. This is just what I did today because it's comfortable. I'll probably be Western Barbie tomorrow.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
And under the convention, like, what do you plan on, like, being a cosplay?
Do what?
On your next convention, what is, like, you're planning on cosplay?
For the next one, I'm actually going to be at Big Texas Comiccon next weekend. It's a 3-day con, so I'll be there Friday through Sunday. So I have to really think about what I'm going to do, because I'm a procrastinator, and I think about this stuff at the very last minute. So I'll probably do Barbie. I'm not sure yet.
Do you plan on doing this like forever, or like do you feel like there's like at some point that you're gonna be like, you know what, I'm gonna dedicate to her family and that's just gonna, I'm gonna take cosplay away?
You know, I don't know, I haven't really thought about it. There'll probably come a time where I'm sort of just tired of cosplaying. Right now is not then, and for me, I'm a professional artist, so it helps bring people to me to be able to show off what I do. So for now, I'll be a cosplayer, but on the side, just as my hobby.
This is your hobby. What would you say to people who want to do cosplay but they're like shy?
I just tell them to do what makes them happy. Like, no matter if it's trendy or whatever, just cosplay is something that you feel proud to dress up as and that makes you happy.
Because sometimes, like, they can be people that want to do cosplay, but maybe they're not comfortable, or maybe they're going to feel like everybody's looking at them and they don't want to.
Yeah. No, I totally understand that. I get sort of used to people, you know, wanting pictures and stuff, but I understand that somebody, like, wasn't comfortable. So that's another thing that you can do. Just make sure you feel comfortable in the character that you're dressed as.
Well, thank you for your time, DJB.
No problem.
Hope to see you in other conventions.
Yeah, definitely. We'll run into each other again.
You guys, so make sure you subscribe and hit that the like button if you like this video, and see you till the next time.